Right now we're going to talk about the anatomy of your crab so you kind of know what he's doing and how he's staying in his shell and the kinds of things that he does with his claws. Crabs are known as decapods, which means they have 10 legs, 5 sets of legs. The first two sets are their claws. Now the left one is the bigger of the claws. It's used mainly for defense, and it's also used for closing off the shell to keep moisture inside the shell and also as a defense mechanism. That's the larger one. On the right side, we have the smaller claw, which is used mainly for eating and for climbing. Now the other sets of legs, they have 4 more sets behind those. The second set and the third set are used for walking. And then the fifth set is mainly used for holding the body inside the shell. Unlike other kinds of crabs, a hermit crab is not attached to a shell, so he uses those back 2 legs to hold himself into his shell. He also has a pliable abdomen that also curves around into the shell and holds himself in. He has 2 sets of antennas, a long set and a short set. Hermit crabs do not have good eyesight, so they depend on their antenna for smelling where their food is. So you'll see those antennas, they almost look like they're talking to you, but they're mainly using them for smell. Crabs are nocturnal creatures, which means they're more active at nighttime. So your kids, they might be a little frustrated, or you might be a little frustrated if they're not coming out as much in the daytime, but in the nighttime you'll hear them moving around and clanking around, and I've told my kids they're having little crab parties at nighttime, and that's when often they're switching shells. So the next morning you come in and your Mr. Hermit Crab may be in a new shell because they are looking constantly for new shells and getting one that's larger as they grow.